This is the BMR
TV News!
Two explosions near the finish line of the Boston Marathon on April 15th killed three people and wounded more than 180 others. Authorities launched a massive manhunt for two suspects seen on surveillance video. Two bombs exploded about 10 seconds and 100 yards apart in Boston's Copley Square near the finish line of the marathon. An 8-year-old boy, a 29-year-old woman, and a 28-year-old graduate student from China were killed. More than 180 people were wounded. The explosions occurred about 4 hours into the race and 2 hours after the winners had crossed the finish line, but thousands of runners were still on the course. Law enforcement officials and family members have identified the brothers as ethnic Chechens who lived in Dagestan in southern Russia. The two brothers have been in the United States for about a decade and lived near Boston. An uncle said, this Yarkov Teznarev, whose father had called him a true angel as a 19-year-old student at the University of Massachusetts in Dartmouth, Tamerlan Teznarev, was a 26-year-old boxer. The uncle, Ruslan Tisnarny, called them losers. Surveillance tape late Thursday showed this suspect number two at a gas station. Authorities said that the two suspects fatally shot a university police officer and then carjacked a man who got involved in a chase with police, then resulted in explosives being thrown from their car in an exchange of gunfire. Tamerlan, aka suspect number one, was wounded and died later at a hospital. At Boston's Cathedral of Holy Cross, Cardinal Sean O'Malley spoke about the city's pain that but urged tolerance toward those who come from the same religious or ethnic backgrounds as the suspects. He was quoted, "Our task is to keep the spirit of the community alive going forward," he said. "We must be people of reconciliation, not revenge. The crimes of two young men must not be the justification of prejudice against Muslims or against immigrants."
Oscar-winning actress Reese Witherspoon's performance as an upset wife earned her a trip to jail. Witherspoon, who was in Atlanta working on a movie titled The Good Lie, was charged with interfering with Pylon's arrest of her husband, Hollywood agent James Toth, on a drunken driving charge. Mrs. Witherspoon began to hang out of the window of her car and say that she did not believe I was a real police officer. Officer State Trooper Pylon wrote, "I told Ms. Witherspoon to sit on her butt and be quiet." Pylon stopped Toth, 42, after seeing him weaving in and out of his lane as he drove through the city's Buckeye community. The arrest report said Todd's eyes were bloodshot and his clothing disheveled. Pyland wrote, after several coordinate tests, he was given a breathalyzer test and registered 0.139, well over the legal limit of 0.08. For driving under the influence charge, the report said. The car was impounded and Witherspoon and Toth were taken to Atlanta City Jail, the report said, as an unidentified passenger in the back seat caught a cab. The couple would bail it out Saturday morning. A court date is set for Monday morning. Having time to sober up, Witherspoon apologized profusely for her behavior. Just to make it thrill.
When all you gotta keep. All juniors registering for the SATs, do so by May 1st if you want a discount. Also, anyone going to the college fair, registration forms are currently in guidance. To all sophomores, check up on those guidance appointments, make sure you don't miss them. Also, the NHS induction is on May 14th. And all I can breathe is your life.
Hello, today I'm here with Mr. Campo to talk about our recent career fair.
Hi.
Mr. Campo, so how would you say this year's career fair went?
I think the career fair went very well. We had a lot of good feedback from the presenters. They were particularly impressed with the students' thoughtful and insightful questions. They really made sure they told me how impressed they were with the students here.
Who's this year's keynote speaker?
The keynote speaker was Hannah Marigi, a former BMR student and graduate. She's now one of the admissions directors at Babson College.
Do you remember what she spoke about?
Yes. Hannah talked about her journey of becoming a Babson College admissions officer and how she went through Providence College thinking the whole time she was going to be an English teacher, when in fact she went as far as her student teaching and realized it really wasn't for her. So she told the kids to keep in mind that their first choice for majors is not always going to be the thing they end up doing when they graduate.
What was your favorite part about this year's career fair?
I'm always excited to have the students come back and give back to the community in the way of presenting. And of the 50 career presenters, 22 of them were actually graduates of BMR. I think that's really nice of them to come back, and I think they can relate well to the students, since they were all graduates of BMR as well.
Well, thank you, Mr. Compton.
You're
you
welcome.
Very much.
Thank you. If I go crazy, then will you still
call me Superman? Here we see Kayla Abel, another senior. How you doing, Kayla?
Pretty good.
What are you up to?
I'm doing my homework.
Are you?
Yeah.
Kind of homework.
The homework in kind.
It doesn't look like homework to me.
It's Nanya. That's what it is. It's Nanya.